This week, Tommy Games, No Man's Sky patch fixes PlayStations, Xbox onesies, PlayStation Now on PC, Deus Ex microtransactions, real life Pokemon balls, Kojima quits gaming industry to start his own cult.
Yeah.
Wow. Well.
Oh, wow.
Oh, there's something.
Centre of attention.
There's something.
Look at me.
Something strange, isn't it? Let's do a quick fix of this, shall we?
Quick flip.
Wow, that's wow. Really good. Because.
Reasons.
Because reasons. Wow. Right. Okay. I think we'll be doing this a lot today.
Flip. It's going to happen every time.
It's probably going to happen every time, but it's fun. There we go. No, I'm back
magic.
Now. Look at that.
Round one, episode 75. Adam Goinsteg, absolute Jew. Everybody calls this
master of cameras.
And tings.
And tings. Right, what's been happening in the world of gaming?
Gaming. Abuse the news.
Abusing of the newsing.
Not that much, actually. Some things. Okay, No Man's Sky patch to fix 90% of PlayStation 4's crashes, which probably still is about 20,000 other crashes.
Yeah, well,
things crash a lot. From what I hear, word on the street.
Yes, yeah, it's a strange one, that, isn't it? It's like with the No Man's Sky, I've been up and down with it.
Do you know what I did? I thought, right, fuck this, I don't want this game, I know I don't.
Right.
Let's find out what the ending is. I'm not going to tell you what the
right,
ending
okay.
is. So I watched some videos at the ending, of the ending.
Right. What a waste of time.
Oh, fucking hell, it's painful. Painfully annoying is all I'll say.
Right. Okay, wow.
We'll forward to that.
But no, I wanted to doss around with it, and then, you know, I've been up and down, and then, Sony. Pushing it. I still reckon Microsoft played enough of it to go, oh no, we're not backing this. And that's why they didn't put up a fight when Sony came in with money for exclusivity. I reckon they didn't put up any fight whatsoever, because it was an indie game.
Yeah, I fuck knows.
But anyway.
I don't even know.
Move on from
it was a good trailer. The PC player count is dropped 90%. This was from last week, so I don't know if you dropped more or gone a bit or whatever.
Well, go on, sorry.
I assume this is unusual just because it was reported.
No.
Otherwise they wouldn't have bothered mentioning it. Or are they just being catty?
Clickbait stuff. What it is, because I was watching something about that, because I'm like, wow, it's dropped that much. This is dramatic. Let's have a look at this. So Machinima do inside gaming little mini news thing, which used to be good, and then everybody left. To Funhouse, and then I started watching Funhouse. Got bored of Funhouse.
Got a bit boring, didn't it?
But yeah, so Machinima did this report on it, and it made out No Man's Sky drops 90%. They then mentioned that this is very common for all games on Steam.
Yeah.
It's because of the Steam tracker shows you how many people are actually currently using it. You've got some stats to look at. Now, with No Man's Sky being up there as a perfect whipping boy at the moment.
Yeah, I wonder if it's probably because they just want to throw a bit of news out there and go, that's a little dramatic thing.
No Man's Sky is still getting headlines.
It's obviously easy to find because it just says it on Steam.
Yeah, it does.
It's just there for you to see. That's that. So
yeah, I mean, I'd be more interested in...
I'd like to see it compared to other big games, though.
Oh, no, they were saying even something like Call of Duty, something like that. They were saying even stuff like Call of Duty starts off ridiculous. People go out and buy it, and then it goes...
It makes sense, doesn't it?
A bit, a week later, they're like, right.
Most people
that
people
are just playing it to finish it.
You'll buy it straight away. Yeah. You'll get excited because of the hype. You buy it, you play it for a week, and then you'll get rid of it. That tends to be what happens, or you get bored.
Well, Deus Ex took me... all weekend, got it Friday night, and then Sunday morning, done. And I'm like,
if you want, show me games. Don't call it new games.
Go and check it out. I'll talk about that in a bit on one of these other things. But yeah, it is a common trend.
Yeah.
What a good stat to find out would be for any kind of game company, you know, an independent game companies to come together and sort of like have a meta online saying which games are the most pre-owned.
Right? Oh, yeah, yeah. You know,
so that way, then you can see the users that are dropping, like say on Steam, still have that game. You might just dip in every now and again. Mm. You played it for a week, you might have put 50 hours in that week. That's a long time to put in on a game in a week.
Yeah, yeah.
And then gone, right, well, I'll leave that on back burner, I'll come back to that. Because they've got it forever. Right? Yeah, some Steam's got it forever. Whereas if it was a console game and it was a disc version, and you start seeing first week sales are this much, and then 60% of that are coming back to shops pre-owned.
Yeah,
that's a negative report.
That's a better statistic.
That's a negative report.
I mean, it still looks shit to me anyway.
Yeah,
to me it looks really, really poor. But that's just me.
Yeah,
it certainly doesn't look like anything like it promised.
No.
official Xbox onesie in Australia only for the minute. I imagine it's quite warm there, so I'm not sure of the point.
Yeah,
but it looks comfy. There's a white one and a black one.
The white one look cool.
No pink one.
No, cat's being annoying.
It's got what's he got? It's got a pocket here to put your phone in, or whatever. Mm-hmm. It's got big pockets here
to put your joypads in.
I don't know why they said joypads. So I was.
I'll put it in. Grab a piss and nobody's going to mess around with my character.
And your remote control or anything really. You can get a gamer tag on it if you pay a little bit extra. You can do that. But it's only in Australia. I like the look of it. I think it, how much wear it? I don't think it said how much it wear.
Well, I'll have to get in contact. There's a lady on.
I'd wear that here now.
Games. Yeah. Oh, I was going to say there's a lady on Shelby Games Group who's from Australia.
Melissa.
I might have a word with her and see how much it is, and if it's reasonable, I might.
Worth getting one imported.
Get one imported by her. Gassy.
PlayStation Now is on Steam. Now.
Is it on Steam or is it just on PC?
PC. It's on PC. Not Steam.
Yeah.
PC. Yeah. I wrote stream here. Yeah. I got mixed up. Which basically, if you don't know what that is, you can stream select PS3 games for £13 a month, but it's like 400 and odd of them. So it's all the ones you're going to want to play.
Yeah, but there isn't anything you want to play on a PlayStation.
If you've never had one, I suppose you could do what I did.
Well,
do you know what
you buy it for a month, don't you? You play Last of Us.
Yeah.
If you don't already have a PS3 or an Xbox.
Yeah.
Or a PS4.
I don't know. click on the list of what games there are, and then pay £13. I think that's per month. And then you can just stick around with all these games and you can just go, right, that's it, I never need to own a PlayStation 3 or I've caught up.
When you finally got a PlayStation 3, how long did it take you to actually play the games?
Not long, really.
Now, you're not a big JRPG fan.
No, no.
This needs to be said. You
need to forget
that. You're a JRPG fan, Sony consoles are the way to go. Mm. They just are. I've got a Vita and that's all it's full of. It's just full of JRPG.
Yeah, I just tried the main ones.
Yeah, the ones that are meant to be console sellers.
The exclusive ones,
like
obviously.
God of War and
Uncharted
series.
Yeah, played the God of Wars and all the Uncharted.
Wipeout's really good.
I didn't try Wipeout. There's enough for a couple of months worth to have fun, I think. Because obviously you're not going to be playing it constantly.
No,
some people might. But I think it's worth £13 a couple of times just to play or catch up on Uncharted.
£13's not bad at all, is whatever. It? Like I say, catch up on stuff. Or
but it's going down that road of another reason not to have a console. I know it's not PS4, but it's PS3, so it means that you can play all that Sony stuff.
I don't think there's any reason why they can't do PlayStation 4 for the PC.
I
think
they're doing
it
that
so
way.
You have to buy a PlayStation 4, obviously, otherwise it renders.
Yeah, yeah.
Not the console useless, it's just, it sort of, you've no reason to have one.
Yeah, because a lot of people have a PC and a PlayStation or Xbox as well, don't they? So.
Yeah.
This will be out soon, 15th of September. It's a DualShock 4 USB wireless adapter, so you can play
on the PC.
On the PC, so you can play those games on the PC with DualShock 4. But you don't have to buy that. You can use the USB cable.
Right.
That you have with it. Well, it's not very long, actually. I don't think.
No, it isn't. It's tiny.
You probably get only one of them.
Yeah, you could do. Yeah.
Maybe you get one with a new controller. I don't know. I don't know what they are at the minute. Yeah, that's all right. That's all right.
13 quid. Not bad.
13 quid. Piss around with all them Uncharted. Catch up. Mm. You right?
Yeah. Got a war on there. They're not too bad.
But yeah, I didn't mind them. They're not mind-blowing, but they're just like...
They're a solid game. Yeah. They're not buying. They're one of those 7 out of 10 games that you'll go back to and play as opposed to 7 out of 10 and leave it.
Yeah. You know. Alright, so I'll smash them. That's not to do with anything, actually, though, either.
Yeah. I want to know. I'm interested now.
It's nothing, really. It's just... It's Man Destroys Internet, right? It's not so much to do with gaming, but it's the internet, so it stuck to me. This Chinese guy he were line dancing or something in the street or whatever he was doing, and apparently these were reported by Chinese newspapers, so I don't know, you can't really tell how true these things are, but it was being recorded and stuff, and apparently that's a bit of a thing for, like, you say old women do it, it's like one of them,
right.
It's like Morris dancing, you'd be embarrassed if you were young and you were doing it, you know, it's not seen as cool, so he didn't realise that people were filming him, so he went to the nearest box, you know, like the internet boxes where they just have all fucking wires in or whatever, and he pulled all the shit out.
What a bastard.
Thinking no one would be able to put it on the internet now.
Yeah because that's the only place. He lives right next to the only... Well, yeah. That's brilliant, I love that, that's fantastic.
That's awesome.
That's something like out of... The IT crowd, isn't it?
Where they have the internet. But
internet in a box with a switch on top. Yeah. Don't drop that, that's the entire internet. That's
if you've never watched the IT crowd, it's fucking brilliant.
Watch it.
And if you just want to see that bit, just Google that, IT crowd.
Breaks the internet.
Yeah, breaks the internet.
Broken the internet.
Fucked up.
Brilliant.
Right, so they're making, there's a Kickstarter for a real Pokeball that you can play with Pokemon Go.
Yeah.
And what you can do with this is literally throw it. You've got your phone in your hands. And if it's near the Pokemon, then you might get it. But what about them flying ones?
Oh, zoo bats and stuff like that.
We work with them. I don't know, because I haven't seen one.
Possibly, I don't know.
Possibly. It's throwing in the air. It's
fucking stupid.
So it's also got... an accelerometer in it, so you don't literally have to throw it, you can just kind of simulate it and it'll do it.
Just we have a fucking swipe.
It's 50 quid.
Well, fuck off.
It charges your phone.
Does it?
Yeah.
So that's the only reason to have it.
Yeah.
But even then, it's a big fucking ball.
It didn't make out like it charged your phone very well, but that is a feature.
Oh, fuck.
So it's got that.
But what's charging that then? Because
you must have to charge it all.
Pokemon Go batters your battery.
Apparently,
ruins it. And then, so you've got that, and then you'll be running around with this thing with some charging in, because it has to run the accelerometer, and it has to be Bluetooth connected to your phone. So now your phone is running that via Bluetooth, because it has to recognise it.
You'll have to have your Bluetooth on as well.
Then your GPS location on it, which is how Pokemon Go works, and your internet, and the app, which batters your phone, and then you're
gonna probably gonna drain it more, isn't it?
Yeah, it's gonna hammer it.
Anyway, they've made the target, which was $25,000.
Let's make shit up. Let's go on fucking Kickstarter. Let's just make stuff up, because you don't owe them anything. Go cheers. We made the budget.
Yeah.
Off your fuck.
Any ideas?
A guy wanted seven, I think it was $7, so he can make potato salad, right? I think he got 38 grand.
That's alright.
He did it as a fucking joke. He got $7 and he got 38 grand.
Wow.
And he uploaded a video of himself making the salad afterwards saying thank you. I think he ended up giving a lot of it, if not all of it, to charity. I'd pay my debts off and then go like, right, everything go to charity.
No, I'd just keep it up.
I was saying that, so like, if it did start something. Mental.
Plus an extra $6,000, so they've made more than that.
Yeah.
I think it's got like 37 days left, so they could make more money still. But there's a slight problem.
Yeah, what is this slight problem?
Just a slight problem with the whole thing. They don't have a license agreement.
Ooh.
Yet. He said yet. So.
What a perfect way to turn around and go, we met the budget, yeah, but like we know how to license it. Money in my pocket, money in my pocket. I might do that for a fucking Sony product.
They could just go, I'll go get the license, fuck
yeah.
it.
Never mind.
It's not like Sorry. Nintendo or Pokemon Company will necessarily give out that. I don't know if you've got a history of that.
No, Nintendo haven't got a history
They're
of that.
They're always pulling stuff off the internet.
Of course they are, yeah, you're fucked if you're
quite protective over YouTube videos with Nintendo.
Yeah,
stuff,
they are. I'm quite surprised we haven't been bought for the. Yoshi and Link that we have on here, but then again, nobody watches this fucking thing.
There's time.
Just
time.
Me and you.
And refresh. yeah. That's just fucking dead.
That's mental.
PS4 Slim controller. So I mentioned the PS4 Slim leak last week. Now apparently there's another leak, but this is a controller. And I don't think it's any different. I heard him say it was lighter, but I'm not sure it is. But you know the touchpad at top?
Yeah.
You can now see the light bar, which is good actually. They haven't put an extra light bar on it, it's just they've just sort of cut a hole in it. I mean, this guy could have just made it himself, possibly. But they've cut a hole in it so you can see it. Now, what the PlayStation controller does is the light changes colour on a lot of games, depending on certain things, and whatever, if you're war health.
Yeah.
And you don't fucking see it, because it's here.
Yeah.
I know it's not for that, it's for your PlayStation Eye and your VR as well, when that comes out. But I think that's nice, because that makes that have a point now. Yeah. For me, I know my health's low. I don't need it on the HUD. If that was an option, mm-hmm. I could just...
Yeah.
Clear the screen and think, right, I'm not so well. I'm a bit poorly.
Yeah.
Because it's red. But it's a nice extra touch. I don't think I'd buy it, but if that is the standard one you start getting.
You'll probably end up with one at some point. But I get what you're saying though. It's a bit like the Colonial Marines pulse rifle. Why is the ammo counter on side?
Yeah. I just want to see it.
One round left. So I know what you mean. It's an
improvement, if anything.
It's
just a little
minor improvement.
A little shift. If it's true, it seems to be. But
yeah, it seems to be. They're not going to mention it too much.
We shall see. My main concern is the points in the big fucking touch button.
There isn't any.
It's pretty much pointless. I was speaking to someone about
just
it.
Just like the back of the Vita is useless.
Yeah, it starts off as a good idea. They try hard at first, don't they? Someone was saying it's on a couple of games and it's all right. But nothing really a button couldn't do. And I just find it...
It is just a button.
It is a button as well, yeah.
It's basically for... When you use it on other stuff, I mean, you use it as a trackpad.
Yeah.
It's a shit trackpad.
It's shit.
But most of the games that use it as four buttons.
Yeah.
Because you can press it at top, press it at bottom, you know. And use it as four different
buttons. I didn't know
like
it was a fucking
kill
button.
Zone.
I didn't know it was a button at first. I was trying to get my map on for something like, whatever I had, Assassin's Creed or whatever. And I'm like, how do I get the map on? I'm pressing all fucking buttons. I could not figure it out. I did not know you could press the whole thing. I knew you could touch it and use it as like a touchpad, but I didn't know. It was a button. And then I started moving around the map with it, and I'm like, oh no, that's wrong.
Yeah, analog, thank you.
back to analogs. Yeah. Apparently there's a couple of games where it's all right on, but it's not necessarily. So I'd get rid of that.
Yeah.
I'd get rid of it.
Get rid of that. Imagine the money they save on the technology now. Because, like, why... I mean, I still do not comprehend why a joypad is 50 quid. When did that become acceptable? When did we just go, it's 50 quid for a joypad now?
What did they used to be? 20
quid.
Really bought. Yeah, that sounds alright to me.
20 quid for a licensed one. And then you're looking at, like, 15, maybe 10 for a cheap shit.
Yeah, one.
But 50 quid for a console, for a joypad...
They should be getting cheaper, have they not gone cheaper?
The Xbox One joypad, I mean, I don't mind the joypad itself, but it feels cheap plastic. I like the joypad, I like the analogs. But it's
the weightiness.
Cheap plastic. PlayStation 4 pad does feel nice now.
Yeah, it does feel nice.
But like I say, get rid of that fucking sensor. Don't cost any money. You save yourself some money.
Might even save some battery.
So, 50 quid for one of these, it's the price of a game.
So if they're not gone cheaper, are they still...
Well, $44.99.
Yeah, you could probably shop around, but basically...
They're about 50 quid.
It's
shocking, isn't it?
I just want a game, don't
you? I want a game, so, like, Now, if you need, if you want to go out and buy, say, a PlayStation, not PlayStation, you want to get a game, a multiplayer game, you've only got one joypad. You're so like, yeah, I'm going to buy a new joypad. Now it's going to cost you £100 for that brand new game and the joypad.
Gears 4 is one of the few big games that has local co-op.
Yes.
So you'd have to buy that and then a fucking controller if you want to play with mate,
You're talking £100 to play a two-player all of a sudden.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, hang on. But whereas when it used to be £20, it could have been one of those things where, like, Adam, man, I want to get this extra joypad. How about you sling us a tenner and I'll pay you a tenner?
Yeah, fair enough. Because I'm the one that's using it
all the time, yeah. So it's fine. And I don't understand why consoles nowadays don't come equipped straight away out of the box with two joypads. They're stupid.
Well, do you not? You can get bundles, I suppose.
They're very expensive, those bundles, when you end up getting multiple joypads. But straight out of the box, standard console definition should be, there's your console, two joypads. Mm. That's a bit. SNES had two joypads.
Did it?
Yes.
Can't remember.
When you bought a SNES, two joypads, there you go, thank you very much. NES had two joypads. Thank you very much, there's two joypads.
Yeah, that sounds ideal to me.
Because
play with your friends, it's more fun.
Play with your friends, this is it. So I don't understand that. Anyway, yeah.
What else we got? Okay, Xbox Gold. This month, mm-hmm. next month,
September 1st.
Terst.
It'll be 6th actually. Do you get the games on the 6th?
Then
6th and then the 13th, I think.
That one. Yeah, I don't bother with the. Right, Earthwalk.
What?
Earthwalk.
Pardon.
Earthwalk.
Oh.
I don't know what that is. I didn't bother clicking on it. It might be alright. That's for Xbox One. Mm-hmm. Ars Creed China.
Oh no.
That's when I'm little.
Oh no.
Dicky Ryan ones. I don't think they're supposed to be too clever. That's for Xbox One.
Oh look, I flipped it.
But we're flipping.
Yeah, I've sorted it out.
Flipping and tripping. Forza Horizon for the 360.
Mm-hmm.
Mirror's Edge 360.
Excellent.
So are you gonna dick around with any of them?
No.
China?
Not a chance.
I never do.
No. It's shit, man. It's like, shit Prince of Persia. Ubisoft.
Yeah.
Don't do Prince of Persia anymore. They do them instead.
Yeah.
And it's a shit version.
Are they all out yet?
No, has the Russian one come out?
I don't know.
Because there's India, China, and Russia is meant to be one of them.
No idea. Sure. No clue. Anyway, that's free. Mm. And,
even for free, I won't play it.
What's that?
Let's talk about a bit of microtransactions then in Deus Ex.
You're going to macro it up?
Yeah. What's your opinion on it? Why do you think people are more annoyed with this one than
any others? I don't know. I think people are just get annoyed by microtransactions in general, even if they don't affect the game. I'm watching, like, Overwatch and things like that.
Overwatch, I suppose it's rammed down your throat in Overwatch.
Is it? Yeah. I haven't played any of these games, but I just see people get annoyed. And I also see a lot of people that don't care. They're just like, well, it doesn't actually affect my game, so I'm not bothered. It's not too intrusive. And you've got them in Halo as well, haven't you?
Online.
And I think it's just a really dirty word now. And that's it, I think.
I think I might start adding to the reviews. You know where I have, at the top of the reviews, are the developer, the publisher, what genre it is. I might put another drop down, another one in there, saying microtransactions, yes and no.
Yeah, yeah.
Just so people know. Because with Deus Ex particularly,
I think it doesn't affect the game. I don't think you should be too bothered.
Well, I wasn't aware there was microtransactions. I played the entire game.
Yeah.
I was not aware of it. Saw loads of fury on the internet about it.
Mm.
Apparently, breach mode, it jumped down your throat. So then I had a look.
Mm.
I'm like, all right. Oh yeah, there's a shop. I didn't bother. I'm like, oh, there's a shop there on your main menu. Not in your main campaign. In your main menu, right there, I'm like, oh, this shop, I didn't bother, I didn't see. So I clicked on it and I had a look. Praxis points, which are your upgrade points.
Yeah, yeah.
You can buy them.
Right.
And you can buy in-game money. Now, at no point during my entire playthrough of that game, now I did everything in that game apart from one side quest, which glitched on me.
Yeah.
And I just couldn't do it, I did everything. I didn't feel wanting for in-game money.
Yeah, you didn't feel the need for it.
There was stuff that I wanted to buy, but it was like, well, it's a game. You get that eventually.
In all games, without microtransactions, you want to earn some.
Well,
they don't make it too much of a thing.
I think Link to the Past, you see a shield in the shop right at the beginning for 100 rupees or something like that. Your wallet can't even hold the 100 rupees at that point.
So
you
see the carrot on the stick.
Ah, okay.
Isn't it?
And with the Praxis, these upgrade points. I didn't unlock everything as far as like the collectibles and then all of the augmentations. I didn't unlock everything, but I didn't need to.
Well, I watched Sterling just before I came here. He was parking on about it. It's a bit boring actually, so I won't bother with it. But basically, he just gets annoyed at it anyway because he's dug himself a trench now where he has to be an.
This is my stance!
Yeah, he's got his stance, which is, you know, fair play to him, but it was kind of boring watching it over and over again. So, he could have done the whole thing in a minute. He could have said, right, there's microtransactions in this game. That's annoying. He could have done it really quick, but he dragged it over, like, fucking 15-minute episodes. So it was... people are getting a bit irritated.
I wrote that review today.
But just to finish, he said, but it never felt like they were intrusive in the game.
It wasn't so.
It just felt like, he said sometimes you'll play a game and then he feels like the game's been changed to incorporate these. He said this feels like they've made the game, that's what the game is, and then they put these on afterwards and you don't really need them. But that's that.
I praise Eidos Montreal, who made the game.
Yeah.
They're the actual developers. I praise them for the game. It's really, really good. All the bad things that I have with that game, which is what lowered my score from, lowered my score from a 9 out of 10 all the way down to a fucking 8 out of 10, which is still a very good game.
It's right? Actually a really good score really fucking, from Shelby Game Standards.
It's brilliant, right? But what dropped it were what the publishers have done, what Square Enix have decided to do,
right.
Which is the microtransactions don't piss me off as much. There's a thing that they've done with a game. Go and read the review, but the game ends. That sounds stupid, but remember Rage?
I play games that just end and I'm like, whoa.
Remember Rage? How Rage
just ended.
I'm like,
yeah.
Right, well, this is what happened with this game. I woke up Sunday morning and went, right, come on, I'll put some more hours in on this.
And meaning then, you didn't feel satisfied because you felt like there was a bit more to come?
I felt as though I was two-thirds of the way through the
game. Not even a cliffhanger, just...
No, I mean, just
gone.
Felt like I was two-thirds of the way through the game and then... I finished this mission, and then it popped up with, you've unlocked a new difficulty setting. Is there a fucking ending? Is this an ending? And then there was this 10-minute ending news sequence. I'm like, that's the fucking end of the game. And I'm talking to Paul, and I'm like, this is Pac-Man. I've even told Paul, I'm like, look, do you want me to tell you which mission is the final mission so you can get your shit in order before you do it?
Some games give you a bit of a warning, don't they?
No, this doesn't. It gives you the same warning it gives you on other parts of the game when you're
about
to
leave the area.
Leave a different area. It'll tell
tidy
you.
Up,
it'll say,
up.
It says, are you sure you want to go over here because your side quests are going to end?
Yeah.
Right? And you're like, alright.
Yeah.
Cool, I'll chill out, right? And it gives you an option whether you want to.
I can relax then.
I fucked off and I did everything. So it just ends. Mm. And because it just ended, it knocked off a half a point for me. I'm like, no, that's half a point.
That's what you're building up to, isn't it? The fucking crescendo.
The story's really, really fucking, honestly, read the review for that part. But the thing that pissed me off the most was there's a section in it called the Jensen Stories. It's on your main title screen. You've got story, you've got breach mode, which is where majority of your microtransactions get involved in. Also, your microtransactions are one-time use. If you use them, you can't start a new game and they're there again. It's like, no, give us some more money.
Apparently, there is a way around that, it's like a bullshitty way.
I reckon
like,
you'd have to start the game, save it, and then have multiple saves.
Yeah, you start the game, and you save it, and you do multiple saves,
right.
And then you can do it.
Through.
Yeah, yeah.
But, the breach mode, which is fucking awful. I mean, really
top
bad. Yeah, top tip. So the game finished, and I'm like, right, so I'm left a little bit deflated from it. I'm looking forward to the third one. It's definitely a trilogy. Looking forward to the third one.
Yeah. Is it stealth alright, innit?
Stealth's brilliant, innit?
Because I started the last one with stealth, and I was really enjoying it, and then it went fucking bullet hell fucking crazy.
I'm a boss.
And I was like, holy fuck.
I covered their chin in the review.
I just can't even, fuck, I was trying for ages just doing this one little bit, and I was having to, because I had fuck all really to deal with it.
Yeah.
I were alright stealthy, but I had fuck all to deal with the situation.
It's because
so I'm trying to be a ninja.
The bosses were bullet sponges.
And it was like, that bit of the game, for me, because of the way I approached it, was incredibly difficult. Incredibly, and I just thought, keep doing the same bit over and over, and I was like, right, I'm done, because I don't know if I'm going to come to another bit like that a little bit later, and it just put me, I had no incentive to carry on.
Think you never,
this could happen again, so I didn't bother finishing
it. Oh, that would have been like your first boss or something, because that's what happens in that game. The rest of it, in Human Revolution, you can play it all stealth, you can hack everything, and you can do all this. Then they put a boss there, and that boss is basically telling you, why have you not put all your stats in combat? It's like, well, I didn't want to. This Deus Ex game, I'm meant to have an option.
I've got the, is it
the Wii U
the director's cut on the Wii U.
It's apparently the best version of it.
And I haven't taken it out of its wrapping yet. I haven't got it for a five or something. I thought, well, I'll have it, because I know the bosses were a problem and certain things. So this, I suppose, like an update really, has smoothed a lot of stuff out.
Yeah, it didn't sort the bosses out though.
So I was thinking about trying it again one day. I've got it there for if I'm ever in mood where I can just fucking...
The stealth is good. If you get caught, you are in trouble, which is fine.
Yeah,
that's the entire point of being stealth. So anyway, this game sorts that out, right? Because I didn't put anything really on any kind of combat.
Did you not?
No, I were all hacking. I could jump really high. I could punch through a wall, because I'm like, right, I need to punch through walls to get to certain places. Hacking is... fucking important.
Yeah, it makes it life easier.
Yeah, it makes it damn so easier. Yeah. And I had jumping, because that means that I can just jump a little bit higher and then I can climb up a place, so I can access every area.
There's one with dropping as well, so you can drop certain things so you don't hurt yourself.
Yeah, you can get that. I didn't end up getting that until later on in the game, because it didn't really matter
necessary,
to me.
Right. I found
workarounds and be like, right, that's going to kill me today. Well, put that bin, and I'll pick that bin up, and I'll pick that bin up, and I'll drop into these bins,
See, I like that. That's why I'm really excited for
it was good. Yeah, there is workarounds. You can do stuff. I was getting in places where I could tell I wasn't meant to be, and it was good. It felt good.
Yeah.
And then the only combat upgrade I got, really, was invisibility.
Yes.
So I could just fuck off. That's all it were. Like, oh, don't
have any trouble.
I'm off.
Yeah. Tell
so,
to me.
And because there's a lack of bosses in it, you don't have that. No, there's just a lot of fucking combat. There's a lot of combat, so you need to get good at shooting yourself and then get familiar. And then obviously you learn from that, going, I could do with a bit more health, or I could do with a bit more.
Yeah.
And that's fine. So after I finished the game, I played a bit of Breach. Fucking horrible, it's the worst part of the game. There's one first person hacking moment in the main campaign, which is what this mini game is. It's first person hacking,
like,
it's terrible.
It's like Metal Gear Solid, where you just put these bullshit modes on.
Yeah.
They're like experimental.
I think they thought that people were going to get right into it, and I wouldn't be surprised if they thought this was how we were going to do hacking in the future. And I think it's getting a big backlash, nobody likes it. But the problem I had was not the microtransactions, it was the fact that I finished the game feeling like I'd only been like two-thirds of the way through the game. And then there's a section called Jensen's Stories.
And this is just this standalone
separate
thing.
Separate bit, outside, after you finished it, and you go...
It doesn't affect the main game, it's just an extra...
Well...
Oh, right.
We go into this Jensen's Stories, and there's one little thing there. So I thought, right, must be a video or something. And it said, warning, do not play these until you finish the game. There will be spoilers in this.
Right.
I'm like, okay. So I started playing it. It's a fucking level. It's about half an hour long, this level. It would have fit, a little bit later on in the game, it would have fit in the narrative. Half an hour long, cut straight out of the game, and put there on its own. I'm like, that should have been.
That's
in
just
there,
to make this
right?
seem like an extra thing, then,
well,
isn't it?
Well, that's an entire DLC. That's where your fucking DLC is going.
Right.
All these levels, which makes me feel like maybe I am missing that third of a game.
Yeah.
Maybe the ending. I mean, the ending makes sense to a degree. It makes sense, but it was very sudden. Right.
Right.
But,
yeah.
But these levels, full fucking designed, narrated, and narrated, fucking levels. which are part of the overall narrative, which give you a bit more of an insight.
So you've got a sneaky feeling that would have padded out the game nicely.
Well,
it got you a 9.
It would have got. It probably would have put. Well, that's why it dropped it down to an 8. Was the fact that they definitely cut bits out.
Yeah,
and no, and that isn't anything to do with VDOS Montreal. That's to do with Square Enix going like, well,
when he's a DLC.
What missions can we take out? Well, that one we were considering keeping it. Well, all right, we'll take that out then. Mm. Does it affect the narrative? Well, no, it doesn't, but it does. See, because my favourite thing about it, I actually read every email in that game, every fucking email. I was like, right, because there's like certain events in the game. There's a bombing.
That's happened. A sign of a good game, though, when you start doing.
Well, I know. Going off previous Deus Ex games, like the first one I played quite a bit, not as much as Alex or Ryan. They didn't even boss that fucking game, but. There's stories going on. There's individual people, and they carry on. Mm. You've got Ogs and Naturals. They hate each other. The two extremes. A bomb goes off in the train station. Starts the game. This is what the fucking main plot's about.
Yeah.
They don't know if it's a terrorist organization. So you're reading these emails and you're hearing all this spiteful shit from these Naturals about. Augmented people, and you have just got to say, all right, and then you'll read perhaps somebody else's, and they're all this spiteful shit against natural people, and all right, and then like later on in the game, you don't need to fucking hack these consoles, they don't give you anything other than
more story,
emails. Most of them go nowhere, like, yeah, I went right fishing, but sometimes you find it's like one email that sort of not necessarily about this bombing thing, but about another event that's happened or something, or you've been reading about. Which is this little innocent party that just fucked up. And you're like, oh,
fills
and then
in the
this
world.
Guy's people hate you and they hate you. And then you hear that, like, you're like, fuck man, that's really good.
To me, that's always a sign of a good game. Really, if you're getting into the little bits, the little
nitty-gritty. So the thing is, the microtransactions for me don't fucking ruin the game. What ruins the game, not ruins it, but what really damages it is the splicing of all these levels. Because I don't know how many levels are going to be coming out. If there's 7 levels, a half an hour a pop, that's 3.5 hours long. That's 3.5 hours out of a 20-hour game that I played. So that is almost a third of the fucking game.
Yeah, that would have been a nice chunk to make you happy with the ending. Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's the main issue that I have.
But you only know if you buy it.
Yeah, and I'm not going to buy it. It can fuck right off. But I am looking forward to the third one. But there is more in that review, so go on. We'll read that.
Check that out on showmegames.co.uk.
Squidgy, 1 second, Delende.
Matt flip. Again.
No, I should have sorted that shit out.
Might as well,
ready? Yeah. Let's move on, motherfucker.
Yes.
Jake sorted it. Let's try and find this week's releases.
New releases.
And macro reviews.
That's beaten.
Guess what?
It was just a quiet one.
Yeah.
For how much?
£40.
£40?
40 of your queen's English pounds.
Sterling.
Jim.
So, you might like them then.
Date are we on? 29th, so I can get to there. Right then. Today, Le Havre, the inland port for the PC. Sounds. Assetto Corsa coming out tomorrow for the Xbox One, PlayStation 4. Attack on Titan. Xbox One, PlayStation 4, PS3, Vita, and PC. It's not on Vita, so
there'll be a few nerds excited about that.
Yeah, there should be.
It does look cool, though.
It does look alright. Blocks with a X, IQ, Blocksic, VR for the Vive. That's coming out tomorrow. The Final Station, Xbox One, PlayStation 4, Mac, PC, Linux. Champions of Ateria for the PC, sounds like a JRPG. Four-sided Fantasy, PlayStation 4 PC, sounds like a JRPG. God Eater 2, Rage Burst, PlayStation 4 Vita PC, winning the best name of the game.
Yeah, what a brilliant name. We should have name of the week every time we do that. I don't imagine anything beating that.
That's definitely winning. Wow, there's a lot coming out tomorrow. Hatsune Miku Diva X for the PlayStation 4 and Vita, Livelock for Xbox One, PlayStation 4 PC, Nebulous, PlayStation 4 PC Mac, one-way trip, PS4, Resident Evil 4, Xbox One, PlayStation 4. I'm tempted again.
Tempted to buy it again. That's probably the game I've bought most, apart from Mario World, I think. Just keep buying it.
I think it's that and Binding of Isaac for me. I've got fucking 19 different fucking versions of it. Strike Vector X, Xbox One, PlayStation 4. Talent not included for the PC and Mac. The Turing Test, Xbox One, PC. Verdum, Xbox One, PS4. World of Warcraft Legion, PC, Mac. Everything came out, yes, tomorrow. Okay, and then on to Wednesday. Neurovoider, that's not too bad of a name. PC, Mac, Linux. Run Gun, Jump Gun, PC, Mac. Shiny, for the Xbox One and PlayStation, yeah, and the PC. Shiny. Tahira for the PC, Mac, Linux, and then takes us on to Thursday, which is September the 1st. Axiom Verge for the Wii U. Why is that?
A little bit delayed. Did it say it's arguably the best version?
Did the developers?
I mean, you'd have to argue that.
I mean, you would say that though, wouldn't you? Yeah, it might have taken us 2 years to get it out, but here we go.
It's probably just because you can play it on your gamepad. But it's arguably the best version.
You get it on the Vita, and can you not get it on the DS as well?
You could probably get it on everything, yeah. just the Wii U.
Fucking madness. Earthlock Festival of Magic, Xbox One. And then Friday we have the Curious Expedition, PC. Mac and Linux, so it looks like God Eater 2, Rage Monkey, whatever it is, Rage Burst, wins that little number.
Show Me Games, name of the week.
Let me get some shit up. Thank. And we're moving on to...
Voice of the Peoples.
Yeah, that's what it is.
What are the Voice of the Peoples?
I'm trying to find them, but...
What are the people saying?
Doink.
There we go. Did not like that movie.
The first one. I've not seen the second one yet.
Is there another one?
Yeah.
I don't know which one I watched.
That's the sound of
the police. The sound of the police.
Sound of action. Right. Sound of pages, the police. Groups. Let's get on this then. Here we go. Man. Nobody's commenting this way. Nobody's watching this.
Wog. Does it matter?
Bitches. right. Okay. So moving down, we have
this.
We're streaming. No Man's Sky wipes your discoveries after 2 weeks. Wow.
No, there was an update on that. Oh. It was more than likely a server error.
Which
is still pretty fucking irritating.
Fucking irritating. If you spent 70 hours on that, fucker.
What a terrifying thing.
Yeah.
And not only that, if you spent 70 hours on it. And then you get to the centre of the galaxy.
I'm going to watch that as soon as we finish. I'm going to watch that. I bet it's a monkey saying, this isn't the centre of the galaxy.
I wish it was.
It's over to the left. we've got Deus Ex review there from First Show Me Games. Opened a new window for some strange reason. Here we go, look at it, all beautiful and nice.
Go and check that out. You can put a little review at the bottom as well.
You can click on what you score it and how
4 out of 5.
Four out of five. Yeah, 4 out of 5, and you can tell us how long it took you to complete it.
How long did it take you? 20 hours.
20 hours.
And is that just the main game or with the extra shizzle?
Well, 20 hours and half an hour.
Right.
Yeah, but I didn't count it as anything. It's 20 hours for the main game, because it's part of the main game. Chris Fishwick, talking about microtransactions again. We've already been through that one. We've got Mr. Edgington. Once it loads up. If it loads up. Things that never change. Assassin's Creed gameplay. War, GTA 5, delays for the PC, Lara Croft's breast size, he gone through, Assassin's Creed gameplay, pushing us war. Okay, that's quite funny. I found it funny. So fuck you guys.
Well, they had a boat, so like that, and then they took him away.
To Assassin's Creed?
He had ships.
He had ships? Yeah, oh, no, I thought you said goats.
No, no, goats.
Like,
goats.
Yeah, that's why I was confused. I'm like,
maybe they did have goats.
They had goats. I thought, what a bizarre update. Yeah. And then we took them away.
Now with goats.
Yeah, I was like, I'm proper lost then. I don't always get flash bang, but when I do, because I threw it. True that.
Yeah.
True that. Yeah. And there's the,
there it is.
The little light on top.
But you know what I mean? He could have done that himself.
Well,
do you reckon?
That's actually sat at the top, isn't it? So that's going to be pieces.
No, that's the light inside.
Yeah, clear plastic.
Yeah, so they've just cleared it. So maybe it's just modded and it's bullshit. I don't know.
See, easy done with a Dremel. PlayStation 1 games for sale and all that shit. Exciting times here.
Strange dancing. I feel like I might be missing something with this. I mean, it's funny. I'll give it that.
Well, you've got Dark Souls with your best friend.
I found it strangely funny, even though I don't know what's going on. Everybody's just happy.
Well, do that. First time I saw this kind of dancing was on a YouTube video, which was saying when you go and pick up your gym buddy, there's a guy running down the street. And then his mate turns up and he starts running, and then they go to the gym together like that, and I'm like, I don't get it.
It would be quite funny if you just got a group of people to walk down the street doing that.
Yeah. Screaming.
We'll do it. Get the bird doing it as well. You get the whole world doing that for peace.
For peace.
We'll create world peace by knocking ourselves out.
Yeah, but it'll be offensive to some small group of people.
Yeah.
They'll
be swearing at some
well, see, black people invented that dance and it's wrong for white people to be like, oh, fuck off.
Possibly. Or the other way around.
Yeah, I think off my Deus Ex review is all lives matter.
They do matter.
Got, what's that? No, is Dark Souls.
Yeah, is it a PlayStation
exclusive game.
Platinum game.
Is it?
I might be wrong.
Sequel to Nier, was it?
But as soon as anybody puts Dark Souls next to the name of a game, I'm
gone. Good. Hitman exclusive target. Took him out the other day.
Have you given up on Hitman after all? No, you're back on set.
Well, they were out for me to play. They took 2 months out of giving you your content.
But did you lose your save on that, or did you manage
to? No, it was saved to cloud, so I was alright.
So you're alright with that
one? Yeah, alright, yeah. I've got the Bangkok. I'm too good.
Yeah.
I went in and just fucking... I killed 2 targets in a busy Bangkok hotel. One of them had security guards around them and everything, and there was a guy having a fight and talking on his phone. The security guard turned his back, went back of his head, walked off. Security guard turned back around and went, it's a dude! Like, yeah, but the fucker. And I pushed somebody over a ledge. I was like, yeah, buzzing, done, 20 minutes. That's how I kill people. I was a bit too.
There's a lot of these about
there. There is a lot of these. These are what happens. This is what your group says when you. I have to make this bigger and more, really, in order for folks to see. When you join a group, you get these chaps saying, wow, that's the tiniest, and you'll talk shit.
I see. So, a lot of people doing that with penis and anything, really.
Yeah, anything. Biscuit, that's the smallest biscuit I've ever seen.
This thing has burnt out very quickly.
after
it came from nowhere and then it stopped.
Well, I thought that because
all the best swear words were taken.
Yeah, they were done. Yeah, there's another one there. What have we got here?
Well, that's an old NES that you could get for quite a lot of money.
Oh, that's alright. As long as it's not cheap.
Yeah, at the time, so it's probably stupid money now. Oh, and you can record your NES games that you're playing.
Wow.
Before the times of Twitch and Tings. It's a proper thing. Yeah.
Wow.
It's a pretty cool thing to have, I suppose, collector's dream.
I'd have it and slag it off.
Yeah, so it seems like these two met in real life. Met on GTA 5, and then became real life friends.
Aww.
Which, I found it quite funny, because I thought, someone's been friend-zoned.
Yeah.
I don't imagine that was the thought going through one of the heads, or both of the heads.
As soon as he turned up, like, oh, we're friends.
Yeah.
We're friends. No, mind you, in America, they're like the average people, aren't they? So they're probably...
Well, like the comrades.
£5,000.
games take away.
There's a... Paul Ashton is on the beta updates for PlayStation 4. Yeah. Apparently, you can now... You can choose whether you do the updates or something like that. It tells you how long it lasts and stuff
You've
like
got
that.
Folders.
Yeah. Booped.
Which is good.
Excellent.
Well, that's a beta, so...
Yeah, so it probably won't roll out. When she finds out that you have money, that is quite funny again. Johnny Floyd.
Yeah, there's a...
Lucky Dog.
There's a few of these as well. These are still funny, though. Yeah.
That's quite good.
Happy times.
That's the 19th birthday of GoldenEye. I watched somebody play the HD rehash.
Right.
I mean, hats off to the guys that modded it, but keep it in your own community. Yeah, keep it in your own community.
Stop wasting eye time.
I mean, there's lots of brand new games that could have been tweaked. Oh. We Happy Few trailer again. It's alright.
Toe Jam and Earl.
Praise be to Santa Funk.
I mean...
So that's now a thing.
that's happening.
That's happening. Toe Jam and Earl.
There's the Xbox onesie. You want to check that out? I think they look pretty cool. I think they look pretty comfy.
The thing is they're a onesie.
They're a onesie, so you'll never get out of them and you'll stink of shit. It's too comfy.
I've never worn one because of that exact reason.
Go to shop in it.
That's wrong. Do you get air with it?
No. Oh. DLC.
Whoa. Dick loving content.
Delicious looking cunt.
Oh. Either way. Alright, Mike, I've got
myself. How much did you say how much it is?
I've got myself a onesie.
This is going to be Australian money. Funny money.
No price on there.
2 million Australian
dollars. Well, 40 quid then.
Maybe, I don't know.
Yeah. So, Dark Souls 3, okay. People playing music.
Definitely happening.
Definitely happening. Facts. I'm still convinced that this is just Trey Parker and Matt Stone getting Ubisoft to troll the fuck out of everybody. They just troll it. Yeah, it will work.
Virtual
like that.
Smell.
They're not going to sell them. They're not. There will be an exclusive fucking stupid limited edition.
Might be a pre-order bonus. A pre-order limited thing, edition.
Which will be really expensive. Apparently it's just fucking stupid. It's pointless.
You could just fart in someone's face.
Yeah. Yeah. So 10 games of gold. And that's Unitoid. So that's all things that you guys have done for us. Rage! I'm gonna have to get rid of that at some point.
Squirtle gonna die.
Squirtle has to go.
Oh, the end of Squirtle.
Say goodbye to Squirtle, everybody. Bye bye, everybody. There we go.
Only have boys, by my knee.
Knee effects.
I get my knee to squirt.
That's going on to. Tool available up at Tap Lover. Thank you very much for watching. Nice to see you later.
Cat's not impressed. Legs go in a bit. See my leg shake.
Yeah, thank you very much for watching. Please click like and subscribe. It does help us in a lot of ways that nobody actually understands. It really does help in ways that we don't understand. It does tell YouTube and Google
There's a pie chart somewhere.
There is somewhere.
Explaining everything.
So, if you're a member of Patreon, for $1 a month, there is a giveaway happening at the 1st of September. It is going to be a large size, brand spanking new Street Fighter V baseball shirt, Batman Arkham Knight, Dark Dying Light, a Dorbs figure, and a 10 division mug. All of which are new, apart from the games, they're pre-owned, but because I can't afford to throw.
Down there on Twitch and up there on the YouTubes in the corners.
Is there?
Yeah.
Have you been putting them in?
It's been there forever. Well, since I put it in a year ago.
All right.
Or whenever you first put pictures.
Oh,
that's
on. Yeah, on the YouTube channel itself. Yeah.
On Twitch. It's down here, I think, somewhere.
Yeah, it'll be right down at the bottom.
Under
the text box.
That says
whatever people are saying. But nobody's saying anything. So
is it not off screen?
Yeah, it's off screen right down the bottom. Right down the bottom.
It says something. It's got a name, I can't remember.
It's got a picture on it.
Did you say picture?
Yeah, a big picture on sticker.
There.
See?
Right there. Simples.
Deus Ex review. There's a new Binding of Isaac series on the YouTube channel. Go and click like and subscribe whether you like it or not. It's something me and Liam are doing.
Or click don't like and subscribe.
Yeah. Ooh. I think you might have just blown people's minds. And for those people out there who spend a lot of time on their laptops or are on the PCs, go and check out a little retro game that's online. It's called Midnight Mew. I've mentioned it before. Mm. It's a browser-based strategy game. Yeah. Midnight Mew is multi-user, it stands for. Midnight multi-user, it's kind of like you manage soldiers and stuff like that. You can get into like week-long wars with people. And it's alright, go and check it out. Run by just one guy at the moment, but there's a big community on there. Go check it out. It's fun.
Is there not? Is there a tournament, a retro thing this weekend? Or is it?
This weekend. That's a good thing. Yeah, because I'll have to be there, won't I? Otherwise, it won't be getting streamed. Won't be done. That is right. There is a retro games night.
Just reminded him.
Yeah, nice one. Retro games night at the Batcave. It is going to be the best games, best console games of each console, apparently, is the theme this time. But we will be doing a tournament of King of Fighters 14, which is a brand new...
Shiny new one.
Shiny, shiny new one. So get your asses down to this, and we shall see you later. Alligator.